Desai here. I represent the Observer Research Foundation. And we are gathered here today to discuss something which is very critical, but which has been continuously ignored by the railways in Mumbai for the past several years now, for decades together. And so I welcome you all to World Mumbai to discuss a potentially life-changing concept which, if implemented, can really save lives on the Mumbai Suburban Railway. We know that about 3,500 people die on average each year, and which, to put in context, is like the Bhopal gas tragedy repeating itself relentlessly, unstoppably year after year, and we don't even blink at bat an eyelid. So that it doesn't make any difference to anybody. I think it's high time that people who have been fighting for it, and what we've generally seen is that there are a lot of community organizations, associations, a lot of them influenced by political parties, and all of them were working for the same cause. But unfortunately, we all have been working in silos and not really interacting or coming together on a common platform to gain that strength in the voice, that collective strength of the voice, to really make the railways sit up and take notice. And it's not that the railways doesn't know about it, but then there are certain constraints. The railways have some long-term mega plans, which nobody knows when will be fruition and when will be commissioned. And this is really the same simple example of the road overbridge at Yogeshwari. It can't be held up for ages together, right? It is a matter of some 7-8 shop owners or some gala owners who are putting a spanner in what can be life-saving thing for a whole lot of people. And so what is at stake here is not just the ordinary commute. So in March 2015, ORF Mumbai released this report called Killer Tracks, saving 3,500 lives in Mumbai Suburban Railway System. And it basically captures the situation as we all know it, and there's nothing new to add in that. So it's something as common and very general knowledge in Mumbai. But it's something that we never take notice of. We never get serious about it. It's become part of our lives. The hassles of the regular commute by train is something which is so intrinsically that has become a part of our lives. That it's like, you know, something like the absence of proper sanitation facilities in the city. But it's, we all know that, okay, if it's a public toilet, it's going to be bad. And we all know that if it's going to be local trains, it is going to be overcrowded, we'll go travel like inhuman loads, especially during peak hours. And so what can really be, like, we made a lot of recommendations, some very far-reaching and even very drastic recommendations, including something as challenging. As what is the Indian Railways and the Western Railway and the Central Railway doing something, are doing in Mumbai on the suburban section, which is a daily commute for all of us, which is a metropolitan mass transport for us. It cannot be connected by any means with the larger, in the larger context of the Indian Railways. So we have examples now, all the metros that are coming up are private, or they are at least in the domain of a separate kind of a organization setup, which can control and operate things, which can plan things and implement the future plans on their own. So why can't something similar be done for Mumbai? At least we can start by beginning by having a separate zone or a separate division for Mumbai to at least get the right focus in. But well, those are all the long-term things and something that will always end up in a big major tug of war. But what is potentially a low-hanging fruit and that can have an immediate impact, maybe in a matter of a few months or after implementation and after going through the teething troubles after post-implementation, is this concept of cyclic timetable. A very simple yet a very game-changing kind of a concept which was constructed in the 1970s by Mr. Deepak Gandhi. And Shri Deepak Gandhi has been an amazing crusader, a very inspirational leader in his own right for the implementation of this cause. It had also in the 1970s been implemented in some sense by the railways. And there are minutes of the DRUCC, I think, of 1972, and a letter from the then Railway Minister, Mr. Madhu Dhanbate, who has actually congratulated the MSRP, that's the Mumbai Suburban Railway Passengers Association,
for having really brought a lot of made a lot of change and a difference, big difference, to the quality of experience of an average commuter in Mumbai. So what went wrong? Suddenly, like as new dispensations came to power and new dispensations came into the administration of the suburban railways, both at the Western and Central Railway, the concept of cyclic timetable, which in a nutshell can potentially, which means like, you know, a cyclic pattern of running of trains with uniform frequency, which can operate in ideal conditions with clockwork precision and with a dedicated sector-wise load dispersal, so which never happens today. So that if I miss a Borivali fast, then I will scratch my head to find when the next one is available. And if I miss a Borivali slow, then I'll try and get into a, like whatever way, and maybe change at Dadar or Andheri or whatever, but try to reach my destination by the time that I have planned. And these also, the cyclic concept also introduces, perhaps for the first time, dedicated sector-wise services. Like almost all the trains will run on dedicated tracks. They will go up and down in a single direction. So the utility of the existing rolling stock will increase by leaps and bounds. Considering the current headway and everything, we will also end up in multiplying the frequency almost by 30% overall, if you talk about the overall context. And so Mr. Deepak Gandhi has been fighting for this cause for decades together now. But then every time that the railways will come with a laundry list of reasons why this cannot be implemented. And luckily for us, when we released this report on saving lives on suburban railway, we got in touch with Mr. Vivek Sahai. In fact, he had reviewed this report. And it turned out that he was a big proponent himself and a big believer of the potential of the suburban railways in saving lives of commuters. And since April onwards, under his leadership and under his expert guidance, Mr. Deepak Gandhi and ORF, we have formulated a remodeled timetable. The basic concept very much remains the same. It's like just tweaking things here and there, which according to Mr. Vivek Sahai has now become practicable. And it can be implemented as is, given the will and the political will and the administrative will. So we basically want to just present the salient features of that, of the new timetable, and invite feedback and suggestions as to what, how more it can be tightened, what further we need to do do away with the challenges, and especially in terms of a whole lot of advocacy that we will need to do in convincing the railway officials and the ministry and the local politicians that this is indeed something that needs to be done. It may not cost thousands of crores, and it might not be really as attractive for them in that sense, but it's something that will save lives and it needs to be done right away. So with that, I'll just hand over the mic to our colleague. In fact, I'll just give you a brief introduction of Paresh Rawal. He shares the name with a famous actor. But what he's doing is also, and I'm great, Mr. Vivek Sahai is here. So please come in. Yeah, thank you. Kulkarni sir, thank you. Hi, we'll just shut it down for some time. It was quite recently, about I think a few weeks ago, that Mr. Deepak Gandhi got a call from Paresh Rawal, and I suppose he was the actor, but it didn't turn out to be him, he runs an organization called LYPD. It rhymes with the LAPD, but it's Live Your Personal Dreams. And they are into virtual talks on some very, very important social challenges that confront India, and especially Mumbai per se, in terms of a whole lot of things, housing, sanitation, women's safety, child abuse, and all of that. So they get experts and make them interact online. And they are growing as one virtual conference kind of a platform. And so basically he came on board, and what he did was actually deconstruct or demystify the concept of cyclic timetable into some very simple presentations. Some of the printouts are there with you, but I think they are in black and white. But in color, they look more vibrant, and it gives the explanation quite clearly. So I'll just invite Paresh to just give his remarks for 5 minutes.
Thank you.